Hey, welcome everyone. I'm Julian Gruber. I'm from Bavaria in Germany. And I'm going to talk about reactive desktop applications. First, do you hear me well? Is this okay? Okay. If the text at any time is too small or you don't get something, just tell me. I think we'll have Q&A after the talk. So if you have long questions, keep them for afterwards. But if you just have a short question, just ask me. And also, I will do some live coding. And if you spot an obvious mistake that I don't see, please tell me. Okay, so I'm going to talk about reactive desktop applications. First of all, who of you has created a desktop application themselves? For personal or for work? Okay, some. Okay. So, who of you has used React? Okay, and who of you is familiar with React? Like, or know some about it? Okay. So the reason I'm calling this reactive desktop applications is because it uses the UI patterns implemented by React in a way that the DOM or the views constantly react to changes to the data structures without you explicitly updating the view. And for this, we are going to use three main technologies. React, I've mentioned before, for all the view logic. Electron, which brings the Chrome runtime to desktop as something that you can use to create your own applications. So Electron is like where all happens. React is putting all the view together. And the third part is LevelDB. And I'm going to talk about it in a second. Okay, so as I said, Electron, Chrome is a library. This empowers you to create desktop apps using JavaScript, HTML, and CSS. So if you're a web designer, if you're a web developer, if you're a regular developer, you can create desktop applications using it. And Electron was ripped out of the Atom editor by GitHub. React is the UI framework. It's component-based, so everything you see on the page is a component, like the footer is a component. Oh, sorry, you don't. The footer is a component. A blog post is a component. For example, Facebook is built using React, and every post is a component and stuff like that. And it uses JSX templating, which you will see once we get to the coding, which can be weird when you first use it or see it. And it's still weird to me at this day, but it works. Okay, so the third part in our equation is LevelDB. And don't worry, you will see this used in a second. But just so you understand, LevelDB is a key value store implemented as a C library. And this is used in Chrome for IndexedDB and I think InnoDB. And like it's the database layer of Chrome, but available as a general purpose library. And we created a binding so you can use LevelDB inside Electron or LevelDB inside Node.js. And you will see why this is handy with React in a second. Okay, so to make this all work or to put this all into context, I'm going to create a to-do MVC implementation. Who has heard of to-do MVC before? Okay, some. So to-do MVC is something designed to help you pick a framework to use. So for example, okay, I have Wi-Fi. To-do MVC is popular implemented in those popular frameworks. And for example, if you go to the React one, you see you have a to-do list. You can add stuff. You can filter active, completed, all, clear, completed, see the items that are left, rename items, mark all, mark none. So they picked this kind of application to evaluate how well a front-end framework works. And what I did, I thought, okay, I will do this, but with React and Electron. With all those features that I just mentioned, with some extra feature, and I will implement it, or I saw that I could implement it in 170 lines of JavaScript, which, given like all those features, seems pretty efficient. I mean, this is a contrived example, but still, to me it was interesting to see that you can do all this in so few lines of code. So let's do it now. Is this readable? No? Yes? Should I make it bigger? Is this readable? This? Okay. Can anyone not read this? Okay. So I set up the basic example. This is in Electron. I just made it full screen so we have more space. And this is your template. It doesn't do anything yet. It's just the DOM. And yeah, this is the code for it. Okay, so in React, even your main application is a component. And in the render function, we currently just return all the DOM that you saw on the page. And you see that's JSX. It might look like a syntax error if you haven't seen JSX used before. But actually, we're using the Webpack transpiler to turn this into valid JavaScript. So there's no extension running in Electron that makes this happen. It's a compile step. And on the command line, I'm running Webpack in watch mode. So whenever we change something in here, the build is updated. OK, so the first thing we want to do is, yeah, we want to add stuff to the to-do app. First of all, we need the LevelDB module. So you might be confused, but LevelDB, since it's a library and not a standalone database, you can just use it as a library in your JavaScript code. And instead of running a database command on the terminal, this is how you create a DB. And this DB is going to live on the file system as inside your DB folder. And to clear the DB, you remove the folder. Okay. So we have the DB. And what we wanted to do is create a get post into the DB. We here have a form to make a new to-do. And we say form on submit. Call the this.onSubmit function. And onSubmit. So we need to know the text that was entered here. And in React, I marked this input element with a reference so I can access this.refs.add.value, which will give me the value of this item. So in our database, the value is this. And the key that we are going to store it at is just some random key. Don't worry about this. You will see why it makes sense in a bit. And then we put the key value pair into the database. Let me just tell LevelDB that our values are going to be encoded as JSON. Okay. Oh, and probably we should call event.preventDefault so the form doesn't reload the page when you send it. Let's see if this works. Okay, so it's storing it in the database. We just don't see it yet. Also, you shouldn't be impressed yet. Like, that's just setting up the thing. Okay, Here we have our unordered list of list items, which is this list. And currently it has one item, but we need to make it dynamic, of course. For every new to-do item that we're storing in the DB, it should render this. And there's a module for this called level list or React level list. And you will see why this is pretty awesome in a second. So as with everything in React, everything is a component. So when you create a list using this, it's an entity of markup that you put into your render function. You pass it a reference to the DB, and you pass it a render function, which gets called for every item in your DB. So we take this dummy code, put it into the render function, fix indentation, and say here we would like to have value.text. Okay, let's see if it works. No, it doesn't, which is the joy of live coding. Wrong method name. It's called render row, not render item. I made this library, but I keep forgetting how things are called. Okay. Hi, what is up? Okay, so already you see the list is updating as we are putting new stuff into the DB. And I didn't write any code to keep this list updated. I just declared that here we want to have this list of values in your DB. Let's just fix the onSubmit method because we need to clear the input. Okay, so now this already feels like a basic to-do list. And you see this is very declarative code. Okay, next thing we want to do is here it says how many items you have left. So currently it should be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And when you check something, it should be 6 and so on. And when you add something, it should be 8. And if you are not using something like React, you would write code for if there's a new item, increase this count, or maybe when the item count changes, update the item count. But with React, that's not what you do. And especially when using React with LevelDB, it's even more simple. Okay, so we have a list component. We also have a count component. React level count. By the way, if you're interested in seeing how this is implemented, it's on my GitHub, Julian Gruber, React level list, and React level count. Okay, so here in the DOM, we have currently 0 hard-coded. Instead of 0, we want to have a dynamic count. We create the count component, pass it the DB. We could tell it only count items that start with this prefix or something, but for now this is not necessary. Yeah, we give it the DB. And let's see what it does now. Okay, it says 7 items left. If we add a new one, 8 items left. 9 items left. That was pretty easy. We need to change it later on, so if it's 1, it should be 1 item, not 1 items. But let's do it later. Okay. Next, let's implement checking off items. Currently, our item structure is like this. It just has a text property. So we want to add a property which is completed, or complete, whatever. And by default, it's not complete. If you create a new to-do item, it's not complete. And let me clear the database because our schema changed. Okay. Yeah, our database is empty. Now, in the DOM component we care about is this one. If this checkbox is ticked here, we want to mark the item as complete or not complete. Should I make this bigger still? Okay, I'll just make it bigger. Doesn't harm. Okay, so on change, this dot on change, and checked, I think, checked is the property name, is whether the value is checked. Okay, let's implement the on change method. This on change method, given a key and a value, will say value.completed is true, and then db.put key value. Let's see if this works. No? Okay. As always, when stuff isn't working, console log and change key value. Does it do it? Yeah, it does do it. Probably we're missing what React is telling us here. Yeah, you need a key property on those items. So this list item should have a key, and as a key, we'll use the LevelDB key. Maybe that's enough to get it to work. Not yet, but you see it's calling the onChange function. Yeah, it's not called value.checked, it's called value.completed. Static typing would have prevented this error. Okay, it's almost working. Yeah, we need to change the class name for the CSS to take effect. Class if value.completed. It's completed, I think. Otherwise, undefined. Okay, just one more error. Class name, yeah. Thanks. Okay, almost. This seems wrong. Let me peek at the solution. This seems right. Let me check if there's something else wrong. Yeah, of course. This toggle method is wrong. If it's already completed, we should mark it as not completed. When you're coding this at home, it's all simple, and then you're doing live coding and you forget how a toggle works. Check? Okay. Okay, now we can mark two items as completed. Add new ones, mark them as completed. Okay. Let's add the function to delete a to-do item, which now shouldn't be very hard. You have this button to destroy. On click, you call this function. This dot on destroy, or call it delete key. On delete key. db.delete key. Let's see what happens. Yeah, and you have a delete. So I'm hoping you're starting to see how simple or effective this code can be when you directly tie your database to your DOM, to your views. And this is not really possible in the web because the database is somewhere on Amazon or something, and like it takes a while for those two to talk to each other. But in Electron, although it's a web environment, it's also not a web environment because it's living in your controlled Chrome environment. It's all local, so you can afford to set up this kind of direct connection between your views and your data. And this is something I haven't seen before. So I think it's an interesting space to explore. Okay, but we're not done yet. More features. You see here this count, how many items are left. It should ignore the completed to-do icons. The count module takes a filter function. Given a value, we return completed. Yeah, I forgot how the word is spelled. So you should only include it if the value is not completed. Yes, two items left, three items left, 2, 1, 0. Okay, that was also pretty easy, just add a filter function. Yeah, let's fix this bug. It should say one item left. The count module also takes a render function, which given the count should return some DOM. And we say if the count equals one, say one item left, otherwise say count items left. Error. Yeah. One item, zero items, two items. Okay, that's not too much more we need to implement. We could implement the clear completed next. It's quite kind of trivial. But let's do the inline editing feature. Sometimes inline editing can be a pain to set up. You can use Content Editable for this, but Todo MVC comes with a CSS only solution, which is really simple. So, given your list element, we add a on double click attribute, and when it's double clicked, set on start edit, and the function on start edit. Okay, also needs a key. Sets some state. In React, each component can have a state. The state is used internally for the component, is not exposed to the outside world. We override the constructor of component and say this state is an object, and we have an editing or an edit field. In this field, we store which item is currently being edited so that when we change this, React will update your DOM. And on start edit, we call the setState method to set this key as what it's currently being edited. And then we also need to make sure the class name changes, because if this.state.edit is equal to the key, it should be editing, I think. Otherwise, complete, etc. Okay, it's already enabling, turning on the editing, but it shows the wrong content. Here we have this input that is used. It should be value.text. Okay, Now we also want to autofocus this for a good user experience. There's a trick in React where you can get a function, give a function as the reference, and once it has the input, call focus on it. Okay, now it's automatically focused. Next, when it blurs, update the item with the new text. On blur, this dot on stop edit, and we pass it the value via the event and the key, and like we pass the event for, or we rather pass event not target dot value. Yeah. On stop edit. Text key value. We say value dot text as text stored in the DB and set the editing state to null again. Let's see if this works. Features 1.1.1.2. Yeah. And it started more stuff. Something else you need for inline editing is when you push enter, it should stop editing. We have an on key press method. If the event dot key, I think, is enter, call the same method. Let's see if this works. More stuff here. Enter. Yeah. Okay, we are almost approaching feature completeness. And currently this is 128 lines, including all the DOM. So it's still not much code, I think. At least in comparison to what you might be used to doing without React. Let's implement the clear completed function. On clear completed, we create a read stream on the database, which basically gives me all the key value pairs. And for each key value pair, we say if the value is completed, delete it from the DB. This on clear completed method is called when you click clear completed. Also, I'm making this quick because I understand it's already late in the day and we might get to some more interesting questions afterwards. Okay, two are completed. Click clear completed and nothing happens. On clear completed is not defined, which probably means there's a typo. Oh, yeah. Cool. Clear completed. Our count is still working. Nice. Next thing is you want to filter by active, completed, or all to-dos. This is also not too complicated. If you know how it does, how it works, I mean, it did take me a long time to implement this to MVC with this method, but once you know how to put everything together, it seems at least it seems not like too much tedious work. Okay, so in the state we want to store a filter function, and we have here filter all or show all, show active, show completed. By default we say show all, and the show all function just always returns true. The show active function takes a value and returns whether it's not completed. The show completed function takes a value and returns whether it is completed. And now we pass this filter function to our list component and given a value, this.state.filter value. We also give this list component a key so React knows when to update this. Okay, let's see. And we also, of course, need to hook up those buttons. Otherwise, no worky. Filter all is on click. This.setState. Filter this.showAll. Show active. Show completed. Show active, show completed, show all. And we just need to update those buttons so they reflect the state of what is currently selected. Also, you see the items left count is not updating because it always just counts the active items. Let me look up the solution because this is not really interesting. Yeah, we just need to change the class name if the filter function matches this. If show active, if show all. All active completed. Nice. Only one tiny feature left. Here we implement a select all. Cool. This shouldn't be too hard now. This is the label on click. We call the function this.onToggleAll. And the implementation is similar to what we have here, I think. Let me take a peek. Yeah, okay, let me just copy and paste this. This is not super interesting code. Basically, we create an array of items, iterate over all the items, then say all is completed if for every item it is true that the value is completed. And then for every item, we say mark it as completed or not completed. Yeah. All completed, none completed. All clear completed, state is correct still. All is good. Yeah. Okay, so this is a full implementation of to-do MVC in less code than I thought. I think I forgot something. Probably. Yeah. Yeah, there's one thing I forgot. Okay. We have 5 minutes. Then we have 10-minute Q&A. So this clear completed button should only be shown when there is currently completed to-dos that you can clear. And to implement this, the solution I really like is, again, to use the count component. Whoops. Use the count, pass it the DB. Filter by whether the value is completed, and then pass it a render function. And this render function gets the count of completed items. And we say if the count is 0, just render nothing. But otherwise, render this button. This is basically an if that is continuously run against the database. Yeah, no button, one button. Okay. Now we have to do MVC implemented. If you're curious to read through the code, it's on my GitHub, github.com, Julian Gruber, to do MVC-React-LevelDB-Electron. It's not a sexy name, but who cares? Yeah, I'll take a picture. And the core takeaway for me with this experiment, because currently, like, I'm not using this in production or for a company, but the core takeaway of this experiment, well, professional speaker, is that the desktop, even if you use Electron and think you are in a web environment, is still its own platform. And when you use Electron for the desktop, it's neither the web nor the desktop. Like, it's neither the web nor native desktop. It's something in between. It's its own platform, and that means you have to think of the proper methods to use. You can't just say treat it as a web environment. You also can't just say treat it as native. You have to re-evaluate, rethink, and innovate, because there's a bunch of stuff that is now possible that is neither possible in native or desktop. Thanks.